be doing a little documentary on my friend Cindy, who's just received a colostomy bag. Let's go on in her room and check things out.
Everything sounds really good right now.
Let me check the stomach real quick. Make sure it's the right color. No swelling. Very good. All right, Cindy, what's next is that since you're being discharged, I'd like to go over a couple of things with you. Mainly how to take care of and clean your stoma.
Okay.
Okay. If you have any questions along the way, just don't hesitate to ask.
Cindy, you did good. You were successful at changing your first colostomy bag. How do you feel?
I feel a little bit more. I'm not freaking out about it, so.
Are you pretty confident that you can do this at home by yourself?
Guess we'll find out, huh?
Well, if you'd like to go over anything before you leave, just let me know and we can do that.
Okay.
All right?
Thank you.
All right, you guys have a good one.
These are my supplies. You want to make sure that you get your supplies out beforehand.
Okay.
Because as you're changing your bag, you don't want to be fumbling through because your stoma is going to be leaking. So the supplies that I have a saline solution that I use to clean my stoma area and my skin.
Okay.
I have the stoma powder, which I use as on my skin as a barrier. It helps protect your skin from the actual adhesive. And these are the adhesive pads I use to remove the adhesive. That just helps because sometimes it gets really stuck on there, and it helps, you know, so I don't have any skin tears. And these are just extra towels that I have just in case I make a mess, and I probably will make a mess.
And how often do you change it, your colostomy bag?
I change it up to 4 times a day, but it just depends on how active you are. You just want to make sure that it doesn't get too full, otherwise it'll spill and you have a big mess on your hands.
Okay.
All right, and I have my scissors are here, and of course the adhesive. And this is my stoma sizing chart. Basically, what I do with this is I measure the size of my stoma. I put it over my stoma to measure the size of it. And the reason why you want to do that is because when you put the adhesive on, you want to make sure that it's the right size because it protects it better and prevents leakage.
Okay.
That is 4. So let's do this. Warn you, this is just day 2 for me. This is my second time actually doing this. So I am a little bit nervous and stressed out about the whole thing. So just bear with me. Well, I'm going to go ahead and remove the adhesive off, and I'm going to use the adhesive removal. And basically, the reason why I'm using this is because the adhesive sticks to your skin really, really good. And you don't want to tear it off because then you can tear off some of your skin with it. So you want to pull your skin back and gently wipe around while you're removing the adhesive like so.
Is it pretty sore underneath there?
I don't feel anything. The stoma itself doesn't hurt because there's no nerve endings in the actual stoma. And plus, I've taken my medication, so I don't feel any pain.
Okay.
I'm just getting around the other side.
Do they suggest testing the skin with the adhesive prior to administering the glue?
Yeah, you want to make sure that you test it so that you make sure you don't have any allergic reactions.
Okay.
Beforehand. Get the adhesive out of the package, like so. Measure it around with a marker, the actual size of the stoma.
So the sizing prevents leakage, is that correct?
Yes.
And you said you replace the adhesive at least once a day?
Yeah, either in the morning or at night. Basically, once you start doing it, you'll develop your routine and you'll know, you know, which day of time is better for you to do the actual stoma care. All right, so this is my actual size that I cut out using the stoma sizing guide. Okay, so before I actually put my stoma on, oh, sorry, I have some goo coming out. That is why I created my volcano. Basically, I just wrap this around my stoma, and what it does is when it leaks, it just catches some of the leakage so it doesn't actually spill over and get onto my skin, being that I've just cleaned it. Just keep in mind, you have to be patient because you're going to have to keep cleaning the skin because you can't control the leakage of the stoma. It just continually leaks.
And how do you protect the skin around the stoma?
I'm going to use the stoma powder. You just sprinkle it on your skin as such. And then it onto your skin. Then you want to use one of the gauzes, and basically you're going to wipe it off to the point where it looks like there's nothing there. Just basically keep wiping until most of it wipes off.
And there's no discomfort during this process?
No, not at all.
The next step.
Well, in order to get the adhesive to actually stick and around my stoma, you have to either use stoma paste or I have this stoma adhesive, which basically works better with me. It comes in a ball. So basically, you just have to kind of play with it. It looks like it's Play-Doh, but it's not.
And what do you do with that?
You want to just take a little piece out of it. And basically, I'm just rolling it up. Until I get it elongated. Take my adhesive.
So you're making a nice seal.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, and as you can see, it's not enough, so I have to get some more on there. Okay, so you create that nice seal. Actually go over the stoma. Oh,
more leakage?
Yes. All right, just a little bit of saline over it. And you want to put it on as such. And there you have it. I'm getting ready to attach the colostomy bag to the adhesive, and basically you just want to make sure that you clip it on there. Yep, and once you hear that it all snaps, it's really good. And also another thing, and I don't have this problem, but you know, I've heard other people do. Your adhesive, if it just gets too close to your belly button, you can always cut around it so that you make sure it sticks to you. So now that the bag is on, we're going to fold it. One, two, three. And and attached a clip on. And there you go. I've completely changed my bag. Not so bad.
And remind me again, Cindy, cost for all of these materials. This is a daily thing. How does that work?
It's actually pretty overwhelming because, of course, you have to make sure that you have a lot of supplies. You need several adhesive pads. You need several colostomy bags. And, you know, you want to have extra clips, and you want to have, the solutions, the powder. So it can get very costly, which it did for myself. So right now I'm just working with, my case manager. When I left the hospital, they gave me enough supplies to last a week. I ran out of those supplies in like 2 days. So I had to go out and, use my own money to buy more materials. And, I live in check to check, and it's not really something that I can afford because you budget for other things. You don't really budget for changing your poop bag.
Well, let's explore other options and maybe take this conversation elsewhere.
Yeah, strangely enough, I build up an appetite.
Let's go eat.
It's lunchtime. I'm pretty hungry.
Why don't you tell me a little bit about the diet that you have to stick on? Is there a diet?
Well, my nurse told me there's no really particular diet adherence that you need to stick to. There's just some things that you want to avoid, mainly because, of course, you have, colostomy and you have a stoma that's producing leakage, so there's going to be odor. So there's just certain types of foods that you want to stay away from. And unfortunately for myself, are all the things that I love.
Well, do you mind if we take a quick look in your pantry?
Sure. So as you can see, first part, it's pretty okay. I have my fiber, which is good. I don't want too much of it because, fiber gets everything going.
I see a lot of beans in there.
This is basically what I want to stay away from. And as you can see, I like beans, but I can't have them. They just cause my stoma to smell really bad. And it can be really embarrassing, especially if I'm out in public around others. You want to stay away from eggs, broccoli, anything that has roughage in it, which causes gas. And I have a lot of roughage.
What about asparagus?
No, that's a no-no. That also causes a lot of gas. An important thing is water. You want to make sure I have to drink at least 2,000 milliliters of water a day.
How much is that approximately?
About 4 8 to 10 ounce water bottles.
Okay.
And glasses.
What about alcohol?
No alcohol.
No alcohol.
So no mojitos.
No mojitos. Some of the food we've had to eliminate from your diet. Do you want to tell me why?
Yeah, mainly because, of course, like I said before earlier, when you're out in public, there could be, an odor that comes from the colostomy, and that can be very embarrassing. So there are types of food that, I was advised to avoid that causes the odor, and it's mainly foods that are rich in, like, rubbish. Which is like broccoli, salad, spinach, your asparagus, and then also things that can, irritate it to actually cause more of the leakage. I can't have any of the cheese or the beans, which I love, any nuts, of course, alcohol, so no happy hour for me.
And these produce too much gas? Or constipation?
Well,
or
all of these foods, they have that effect. So they just advise me to avoid these things because you don't want to be out in public and have, the smelling effects or any gas, because with the colostomy, since it's actually protruding out of your stomach, you can actually hear the flatulence. So it's not really a fun thing. But there's one thing that, you know, I do like that I can still have, which is marshmallows. They advise for us to take marshmallows before you're actually changing your bag. What it does, and I don't know how, but it basically slows down so you don't have that much of leakage coming out when you're doing the changing of the colostomy
it
bag.
It slows your digestive system down a little bit?
Yeah, it does.
Okay. Are there any other things you can do to kind of help slow that process? I mean,
yeah, you can take Imodium as well, and that helps with that. And this has also caused an additional financial burden on myself because, as you know, groceries aren't cheap. They're expensive. So I've spent money, you know, on these groceries that we can no longer have. Oh, my bag came out. Yeah, that's another thing that I don't think I'm going to get accustomed to.
The bag slipping out?
Yeah, it's very embarrassing, especially, you know, when I'm home, it doesn't really bother me too much because I'm around my family. I'm really self-conscious, like, when I go out to the grocery store or if I'm hanging out with friends, and it comes out. You know, it's just not normal.
Well, my nurse at discharge gave me a packet of information, and it basically just goes through a lot of different things. I've been feeling like really overwhelmed throughout this process, and I don't understand, or I don't know how I'm gonna be able to deal. So basically I'm just gonna go online to see if I can find a support group in the area. Can kind of, you know, help me with what I'm going through. She gave me a list with a couple of different resources. The first one is the Wound Ostomy and Continent Nurses Society. There's a United Ostomy Associations of America. This looks like something that could help. It's called Great Comebacks. So I'm going to try this website. There's actually one in the Riverview area that I can go to.
I'm on my way to the ostomy support group because I honestly feel like I've never been here before. It's so hard. Like my husband, like I don't feel sexy anymore. And it's causing a strain on my relationship. I'm constantly self-conscious about it.
It's okay.
I really need to speak to someone. I don't know, like.
So right now, Cindy's heading to her ostomy support group. But we just got word we're not allowed to have cameras in there. So we're gonna let her go to her meeting and see what she has to say on her way out.
Hey, Cindy. Thank you so much for coming to our support group. I hope that was helpful for you.
Oh my God, you just don't understand. It really, really, really was. Before I came in here, I was all over the place. It just really helped me just listening to everyone and their stories. Basically, they're going through exactly what I'm going through. Either they're going through it at the same moment or they've been there. So it makes me feel like, you know, I'm not in this alone. So this was like extremely helpful.
That is wonderful to hear because that is exactly what this group is supposed to do, is to help you share your experience and other people share their experiences so that you don't feel you're alone and that you're going through this by yourself, that there are other people that are also experiencing the same thing. And that's the purpose of this group, is to support one another and give tips and advice to each other. So
yeah, it was great, and I will definitely be back. Thank you so much.
So glad to see you.
Thank you.
Come back soon.
I will.
Hospital discharge, take 3. Rolling.
Well, it is important to know the early signs of how.
Sticking the stoma. Are you recording? Sticking the stoma on.
Play-Doh.
Dang. Food coloring.
Man, that was a good.
I know.
That's what a stoma would look like.
Do you have any Do you have any duct tape?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you're right. Just show your face. Broad daylight. I'm telling you.